Hello and welcome to Newsclick. Supreme Court has come out with a major judgment when it comes to right to privacy. But there's one important factor that also deals with right to privacy and the Aadhaar judgment which is going to come, and that is right to food. To discuss the issue, we have with us Dipa Sinha. She's convener of Right to Food campaign. Welcome to Newsclick, Dipa. So let's start with right to privacy judgment. And what do you think? What sort of judgment it is and what implications will it have?
See, firstly, as far as the right to privacy goes, it's quite a significant judgment. The court has very clearly now said that right to privacy is a fundamental right, which it has always been, but it has clarified that that's what it is. And that is, I think, a very far-reaching judgment in terms of civil liberties, people's freedom of expression, dissent, and so on. So this is really important. Coming to the issue of right to food, if we go back a little bit into how did this right to privacy issue come up in the court at all in the first place. So in 2015, when the court was hearing cases related to Aadhaar being mandatory in welfare schemes, one of the arguments that were being made against Aadhaar was that it was going against the right to privacy. At which point the Solicitor General Mukul Rohtagi, who was representing the government, came up and said there is no right to privacy, so that's not an argument. And that's how this got referred to a 9-judge bench and therefore went there. So one of the things that also happened is that the hearings related to all the right to food and other welfare schemes and Aadhaar got suspended till this right to privacy was resolved. So in that way also, firstly, it's positive that finally this thing is resolved. It's resolved in a positive manner. So we are hoping that this will again reopen and the court will hear the cases. They've already said that in November 1st week, they will hear the cases related to the welfare schemes.
Let's come to Right to Food campaign and the petition that is going to be heard in the Supreme Court. What's the basic thing that the petition talks about and what will the court be hearing?
So the basic issue with all the food related schemes, and this is in different cases filed by different petitioners, PDS, school midday meals, ICDS, various schemes, where Aadhaar has been made mandatory to get the benefits. Basically saying that unless you have an Aadhaar, and then when you're getting the benefits, unless it is authenticated, your fingerprints match what is in the system, you will not get your benefits. And based on our experience, we found that this is actually exclusionary. One set of argument is that why should people be forced to get onto this Aadhaar platform, which is one common platform for so many different things. They're not privacy safeguards. You don't know how the data is getting used. So that is one set of issues which I'm keeping aside for now because privacy has been resolved. The other is the issue of exclusions. The technology is not fully foolproof. Wherever it's been introduced, we are seeing that people are actually getting excluded more rather than getting included. People who are already getting PDS, for example, genuine beneficiaries, are now not getting it because for some reason, say their fingerprint doesn't match. Or the day they go to get their ration, the network is not working and that machine is not working, so the dealer says he can't give it. So there are a number of additional reasons now which have come in into the system to exclude people. And that is our primary contention, that Aadhaar is not something that is forwarding people's right to food, it's actually taking it away from them. And therefore that it cannot be made mandatory.
Right to Food campaign is asking for abolition of Aadhaar in when it comes to right to food, or it should not be mandatory?
As far as when it comes to right to food, what we are asking is that it should not be made mandatory to get benefits under the National Food Security Act or any of the other schemes, and that it should be delinked.
So what has been the development till now? Because there were petitions and court was hearing it, as you pointed out.
So there have been orders in 2015 already which say quite clearly that Aadhaar cannot be made mandatory for any welfare schemes. Okay, PDS was one of the schemes in which they allowed Aadhaar to be used because at that time government made arguments that they really had to do it. But even in the case of PDS, they said it cannot be mandatory. They can use it. So if people are willing to see their data, they can be allowed to do it. But that people cannot be excluded because they don't have Aadhaar or because they're not giving their Aadhaar number. But what's happening in practice on the field is that it's being made mandatory in state after state, including in 42 shops in Delhi where it's being done as a pilot. But the Supreme Court orders until now have been saying that it should not be mandatory. But after that, they also passed this Aadhaar Act, which also they did through a backdoor way where they didn't even take it to...
bringing it as a money bill, if I'm...
Yeah, so they didn't take it to Rajya Sabha where they knew it won't get passed. So all this will now come up in the court and hopefully be challenged.
But why do you think the government is doing that? despite Supreme Court saying that it cannot be mandatory.
See, at one level, also looking at how it's happening on the field now, this seems like, it might sound like a conspiracy theory, but this seems like one way of cutting down on subsidies and cutting back on these programs. Because now if you look at the whole narrative that the government is giving us, you have every day different figures coming up about how much money is being saved because of Aadhaar coming into this scheme. So the Prime Minister on the floor of Parliament said that 3.94 crore ration cards have been cancelled because of Aadhaar. No evidence for that. There was a piece, I think, in Financial Express yesterday, quoting government sources saying 30,000 crores have been saved in PDS because of the introduction of Aadhaar. Now, all of this, there is no basis at all. And whatever little basis there is of the reduction in people taking entitlements post-Aadhaar, which they are interpreting as reduction in leakages. So, for example, if there were five names which were taking rations 2 months back and they are not now, then they're saying those people must have been ghosts. But we are seeing in the field that those people exist. In the case of pensions in Rajasthan, we did an expose also where all the we took the list of people who the government had declared ghosts dead and they were living.
This would be my last question. The Aadhaar judgment, the Aadhaar hearing will start in November. And by December, they are expected to pronounce the judgment. What are your expectations, and suppose if the Supreme Court decides that it has to be mandatory, what will be the way ahead?
Firstly, we hope and also think that the chances that Supreme Court will say it has to be mandatory are low, given two things. One, the previous hearings in the Aadhaar cases and the orders that have already come on this has kind of already shown what the court is thinking. Also, it was because of this privacy question that it was suspended for a bit, and the privacy judgment also goes in our favor. Secondly, in these 2 years between 2015 and 17, Aadhaar has now also been rolled out in many parts of the country, so we have much more evidence of the damage it can do, which we will definitely be presenting in court. In 15, it was more of our speculation of what it could do, but now we know hard evidence. There are people who will file affidavits saying, I have got left out because of this. So I hope that the court will not say it should be mandatory. If it does, because that was your question, I don't think the struggle ends there. I mean, this is a struggle for people's entitlements and rights, and none of this came easily. The National Food Security Act or NAREGA or pensions are not things that came out of the largesse of any government. It came out of people's struggle. So we'll have to see how to build the mobilization and how to pressurize governments to finally not do this. And I do think that there will be quite a reaction on the ground if this continues, because it's affecting people in their day-to-day lives. So it will not be allowed to happen.
Thanks a lot, Dipa, for giving us your time. And I'm sure that Right to Food campaign will have a victory in December.
And
as these things proceed, we'll be coming back to you on Saturday.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Thank you for watching Newsclick.